With Senator McCain's statement that the United States might need to have U.S. troops in Iraq for as long as even 100 years.
I don't even think they should have gone. So keeping them for 100 years, where's the money going to come from? You know, the country's in bankruptcy, and when I listen to this argument, I mean, I find it rather silly because they're arguing technicalities of a policy they both agree with. They agreed going in, agreed for staying how many years, and these are technicalities. We should be debating foreign policy, whether we should have interventionism or non-interventionism, whether we should be defending this country or whether we should be the policeman of the world, whether we should be, you know, running our empire or not, and how are we going to have guns and butter? You know, the 70s were horrible because we paid for the guns and butters of the 60s. Now we're doing the same thing, and nobody even seems to care. The dollar's crashing, and you're talking about these technicalities about who said what, when? I mean, in 1952, we Republicans were elected to stop the war in Korea. 1968, we were elected to stop the war in Vietnam. And tragically, we didn't stop it very fast. 30,000 more men died. So when I talk about these long-term stays, I think, how many men are you willing to let die for this? For something that has nothing to do with our national security. There were no Al-Qaeda there, had nothing to do with 9/11, and there was no threat to our national security. They never committed aggression. It's unconstitutional. It's an undeclared war. And we have these silly arguments going on about who said what when. I think it's time to debate foreign policy and why we don't follow the Constitution
on this stage. Have a plan that you can endorse.
Well, sorry to say that there were a lot of things in this hour and a half that were not discussed. There was a lot of things that they were talking about, who said what when. It was like a court hearing rather than a debate over issues that moved the country forward. And I'm sorry to say that there was those debates, they were lacking a lot of that. I have no idea what the plan is, any of the candidates' plan is on infrastructure. I know only because I know some of the history of those candidates, but none of them really talked about that. None of them talked about healthcare and healthcare reform. Any of those issues did not come up. How are we going to improve our reputation overseas again and get back those friends that we once had? And, you know, they squabbled about a lot of that, you know, did I say this, did I say that? So I thought that was disappointing.
Do any of these candidates have plans on what you talked about, infrastructure, healthcare, also the environment, which is incredibly important to you, that you could endorse?
They do, but I mean, I'm just saying the debate itself, this debate's here today. You know, especially at the Reagan Library, I think it was a shame that there was a lot of wasted opportunities, because I think that they ought to talk. Reagan was a visionary. What is their vision on how to fix the healthcare system? No one today, and the question didn't come up either. It's not like I'm blaming the candidates, it's just the question didn't come up. What is their vision on how to fix the healthcare system? What is their vision on really how to deal with Iraq? What is their vision on how to build and rebuild America and build a new infrastructure that is with the new challenges, though, and invest in the future of America? All of those kind of things, and environmental issues. How do they really fix and fight global warming? All of those things were not really addressed in the details. But like I said, the candidates were not given the opportunity because the questions were not there.